Hi folks, this is all the fruit. I'm on the island of Tenerife. And this nice shrub here is Bosea yerba mora, a native endemic plant of Tenerife. Well, the Canary Islands nowadays are a fruitarian paradise, but before the European colonizers arrived, there were very few edible fruit. And this seems to be one of them. You'll see why I say it seems. I'm here in the city of Puerto, in the Parque de la Sorquía. And in several parts of the park, there are those huge piles of rocks. If you think they were left behind from construction, it's not completely right. Lots of joggers in the park. Well, when the park was created, some British people had a say, and here is a British church. There is a hotel mostly frequented by British, Hotel Tauro. And so they made it like a landscape park and included some of the natural habitats in the area. And those piles of rocks are a very typical natural habitat in the Canary Islands. They are called mal país, or literally bad lands. And they are the piles of lava rocks left after a volcanic eruption. And they are full with lizards, which think that they'll drop something edible. That's why they are all approaching me. They are not scared of people. Look at them. Well, those badlands, they cover hundreds of square kilometers on the Canary Islands. And yep, sometimes like here, they are being incorporated in a park. Usually they are made off of broken up lava rocks, but sometimes the lava is more fresh and, yeah, just in the state it froze and in the state it solidified. And one of the native plants growing in those badlands is this yerba mora, as the natives call it. And yerba mora means the mulberry herb or blackberry herb. Well, the fruit, they don't really resemble mulberries or blackberries so much. And people here, well, the Spanish colonizers, they had blackberries and mulberries. So why did they call this the mulberry or blackberry herb? Well, on the internet it says it's edible. But it says it's edible but not eaten. It says it's edible because birds eat it. So it seems to be edible, but I'm not 100% sure. So please, folks, exercise some caution. Maybe don't eat this plant. I'm gonna try it, of course, but I'm not sure if it's safe for human consumption since all the sources are a little bit unclear. As I said before, the Spanish and the other Europeans arrived, there were not many good fruit in the Canary Islands, and the natives ate a lot of fruit which are not considered desirable nowadays anymore. They are kind of edible, not toxic, but not worth the trouble. Okay, let's try those yerba mora fruit. Here they are. Nice and pink or violet. They look a lot like beauty berry. They also look a lot like glucosmes. Well, they are not closely related to any of them. Let's try the taste. Bitter and with the flavor of raw topinambur, of this raw sunflower tubers. A taste of raw topinambur and also some bitterness. I guess the lizards like them. They like to eat all kinds of fruit. But yeah, I mean, if the taste doesn't get better, I don't care whether this is toxic or not. It's really not a plant for me. Well, folks, this was yerba mora, the mulberry herb or blackberry herb, which neither looks a lot like a mulberry nor like a blackberry, nor is it a herb. This is a medium-sized shrub, but some of them around here are about 5 meters tall and over 15 centimeters thick. Here, by the way, the endemic lizards. A close-up of an endemic lizards, which probably likes the yerba mora. Well, stay tuned for a lot more fruit videos from the parks and gardens of Tenerife, and also from the badlands of Tenerife. And don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe.